no auctions, look.
I know, I've already looked on there. Hello everybody. Saturday morning, 20 past nine. What's the matter?
Got a cold coming. I'm sick, but I can't.
Don't we tell them about that. I've just finished my tea, Sharon, I need another cup of tea.
There's nowhere the kitchen is.
Listen to this. Yesterday, now as you know, we buy stuff and we sell stuff online. Sharon looks after a part of our business which I created many years ago.
Company.
Eh?
You're a god.
And that is selling the t-shirts, the printed t-shirts, and also the printed mugs, for example, like this. We also sell different types of DVD products which I've created over the years. And she packages them up, makes them, and sends them off or whatever. But while she was out yesterday, I got an order come through, and I get as soon as we make a sale, basically, I'll get a little email come through to say that we've got funds going into our account. And I normally have a quick look at it and see that who it's from. And if it's to do with the internet marketing side of our business or the instructional side of our business, I normally reply to these emails. If it's something which is sold, I pass it straight over to Sharon because she's got access to the same PayPal account, and she looks at the PayPal account, prints out the receipts, packages up the goods depending on what the receipt says, and then that's it. It goes down the post office. So anyway, she was out yesterday morning, and I'm just... Oh, here we go. Fucking game. Phone's gone. Hold on. Let's find out who this is. Hold on. Here we go. Hello? Hello, who's this? I know it's you, Bernie. Bernie, I did know it was you.
Being funny.
What time are we picking Bernie up tonight?
About 5:30, because we're going to have some fish and chips.
Hold on, let's put her on loudspeaker, hold on.
About 5:30, Bern?
Yeah.
So I thought we had a bit of fish and chips down there, can't
we? We're going out tonight.
Yeah,
I'll
let her please down then, I'll tell him that.
Yeah, so we'll come down for you at 5:30, and then we have ice cream in the interval, or in the interlude. Yeah, I'm looking forward to it.
Yeah, it is.
Good.
So we'll be around at 5:30.
Yeah, all right then. I'll see you later.
All right then, Bird.
Right, have a wash and a shower.
All right, yeah, all right, I'll do that. Tell Dan to do that.
No, he's all right. See you later.
All right, bye.
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 Gosh, you know, off like a chat. Anyway, that was Bernie.
She didn't get a chance to.
Well, I cut her off in her prime, didn't I? We're going out tonight to Skeggy to watch a show. That's what that's all about. Anyway, where was I? So anyway, so I was looking through the computer and I had a like a ping and an order come in.
The ping?
Shut up, Sharon. An order come in. And I just didn't do nothing about it. I was just seeing it was one of the DVDs which we sell. So I just logged the name mentally just and carried on doing what I was doing. Anyway, when she come in, she normally comes in and she goes on the computer and she does all her work and all that. Or she does t-shirts or whatever. Well, she was just about to print the t-shirt off and I see that she had a DVD which she'd wrapped up in the bag and ready to go off, and it had a label on the front. And I said, oh, because we sell a few different types of DVDs. And she said, I said to her, oh, by the way, I said, you'll be wrapping up a t-shirt printing DVD, I said, for a chap called Mark. She's sitting where she is there now, and this DVD's on the table. And she said, well, I've got to do a t-shirt. I said, yeah. And I said, because I saw I said, you've got a DVD there. I said, I'm just letting you know that the DVD coming in, the t-shirt DVD, was for a bloke called Mark. Mark W, I can't remember his second name. And I just happened to glance over and look at the package that she had on the table there, this wrapped up DVD. And on the front of it, I see the name Mark W something. And I said, what's that DVD there? And she said, oh, a motorbike DVD. And she said, I said, well, you better check that. I said, because I'm sure that bloke is a t-shirt printing DVD. No, it isn't. No, anyway. So I'm looking on the computer, she's sitting there opening it. And I'm saying, reading the email on my screen, saying, hey, you are, t-shirt printing
you
DVD.
You said mug.
T-shirt, you can have your shout in a minute.
No,
anyway,
I'm not going to, no. Yeah. No.
T-shirt printing DVD, and as I turned around, she's opened it up, and because she said that she put a blinking motorcycle DVD in there.
Interfering with me.
And as she's opened it up, she went, oh, you're right. And as she pulled it out, she says, this ain't a mug printing DVD.
You're
she said,
liar.
She said, it's a t-shirt DVD. I said, well, that's what I said. She said, you said mug DVD. I said, no. I said, I told you about this. I said, and then you said it was a t-shirt, a motorcycle DVD, which is why I questioned it. You opened it up, and I said it was a t-shirt printing DVD. That's the whole reason why that I said to you in the first, anyway, this went backwards and forwards. And then she said to me, you said it was a mug printing DVD. Now, as I got a bit older, I start to doubt what I say sometimes. And I was so I knew what I said, and I know that's the reason why I said it. And then she says to me, you said it was a mug printing DVD. She said, look, it's a t-shirt printing DVD. I said, I wouldn't have... Anyway, cut a long story short, she's nearly convinced me. Anyway, in the end of that, I've sacked her.
Yeah, how happy am
I? Listen to this, I've sacked her. I said, you're fired.
Good.
She laughed.
I'm so happy.
She laughed, and then she went like that. Now, what's that all about?
I'm happy.
So we sat here for a bit, and then she went over and pressed the t-shirt, and I'm sitting here like this. And I'm swinging about in a chair, and I'm looking at her. And I said, we don't know who's right now, do we? The older we've got, the more we forget stuff. We come back, and when we lock, like, for example, when we go out and lock the doors, by the time we've walked from the front door to the car outside, I've said to her, have you locked the door? She said, well, I thought you'd done it. And we have to walk back. We forget, oh, what's that all about? But anyway,
nerves,
so,
what's that all
about? So she's standing there printing this t-shirt.
Even though I've been sacked.
No, hold on.
And I'm happy.
I said, you made me doubt myself. I said, I don't know whether I did say what I was supposed to have said to you, which I thought I said. I said, because you got this way of making me think that I haven't done what I've said I was going to do. No, that's wrong, isn't it? See, I'm doing it again, look.
Oh, you're making mistakes, are you?
I said, we're going to have to drop that there, aren't we? I said, we're going to have to leave it. I said, because we don't know. We don't know who's right or wrong. What's going on? Are they putting something in the water? Anyway, we're having a laugh at the joke. Then we get back to normal, so we let it go, like, whatever. We're sitting down watching telly last night. And I says to her... Oh, it was a programme on the telly about someone being sacked or whatever. And I said, oh, by the way, I said, you're reinstated. What did you say?
I'm not.
She says she wants to stay sacked.
Like,
what's that all about?
I'm happy.
I said, I've reinstated you.
It's all right, I'll do me buying and selling on my own, and I've got time with my dog.
I'm not having that. She's nicked all my bleating knowledge and all that, and now she's going from here, I'm here, she's there, and now she's going to bleating on self-employed, like that, on that. And I've got, hey? What's going on?
I'm happy.
You're back in line, you're back on
the
firm.
No, I don't want to come back.
I want you back.
No.
Come here.
I'm taking you to court anyway.
I'm going to take her back.
You didn't go through this.
You're going to take me to court.
I'll get my daughter to represent me.
I've changed it. I've downgraded it to a first written warning.
No. I'm not happy.
Hey?
You sacked me.
I can't. You weren't gross misconduct.
You sacked me.
An argument isn't gross misconduct.
You didn't go through the procedure.
You didn't swear at me. You didn't raise your voice.
That is normal.
So, I've got to offer you a job back.
I don't want it.
Otherwise, you'll do me for... No,
that's right.
You'll do me... For what's the word?
See you in court. That's the word you're looking for. See you in court.
Unbelievable.
No.
Oh, anyway.
You sacked me. I'm
She's back on the tools.
No.
Sharon?
No.
Please wake up.
No. As George would say, no.
Little George is our little grandnephew. He's on holiday. No, he's not grandnephew. What is he?
Grandson.
He's on holiday at the moment, but that's another story. Anyway, so yeah, that's that. So, she's back on the tools.
No,
Sharon, you are. Don't keep on. I've re-employed you. Anyway, hold on. I can't fire you anyway. We're a partnership. You didn't think of that, did you?
Yeah, but you did.
I can't do that. You're 50% owner of the business.
I
can't. Yeah, of course you are. You know you are.
No, I didn't know that.
What do you think a partnership is? 30-70?
Yeah, for you.
You're 50% owner.
Alright, I remember that.
You are? Of course you are. You, when the accountant comes around, don't you remember signing the paperwork?
No. Senior moments we have.
Oh, yeah, well, you are 50%. You're 50% owner.
And now I'm not.
80-20, straight down the middle.
Yeah.
Yeah?
Dale.
Anyway.
Where are you going now?
Just
show. I want my cup of tea, baby. Oh, look at this. Come here, come on, Jimmy. Yeah, listen to this, look. He's got one, what are they called? Balance ball, hoverboard, or whatever.
So good on it.
Look, I think they're dangerous. Look at it. Look how smooth.
Oh yeah, don't go back.
Look at it. He's got a hole in his trousers. Now look at that thing, look. Unbelievable. So, I had a go of it, because years and years ago, I used to be a wizard on the skateboard back in the 70s.
Years ago.
I come straight off it, and I said, that's a dangerous tool, bicing it away. Gary, his big brother, went on it. How long ago was that, Jimmy?
Ago.
What did you look at the clock for 2 months ago? He just looked at the clock and said 2 months ago. He come off it in our living room, Gary. He was giving it all the big one. Last week, he went, no, was it last week?
Yeah.
He went to the doctor's. I said, what's that for? Oh, a problem with his elbow. And it's since he's fell off of that thing and he's been in pain with it for 2 months. And because he fell off it, didn't he, Sharon?
Pancakes.
You didn't make them, Sharon. You've heated them up in the toaster,
yeah,
baby.
Yeah, I didn't make them, did I?
She's heated them up in the toaster. But I think they're dangerous.
Yeah, but you're old, you would do.
Well, I'm not old, Sharon.
Martin, you're not his age, you think of the fun. You think of falling off and hurting yourself.
He's a bloody grown man, Sharon.
Yeah, you had a motorbike, that's dangerous.
That's not a motorbike.
No, but I'm saying you're a different thing to what he's got.
It's a reaction thing. Speed and reactions. He makes it look easy. Oh! Who is it? Oh, I'm filming, baby. Just open the door, Jim. Who is it? Oh, God, I'm at the door.
Shut the door.
Who is it? I'll stop what you want. I'll stop what you want. Stay there, dogs. Get back. Hello, mate. What's the matter? Oh, right, yeah. I'm a bit busy at the moment, mate, to be honest with you. Oh, no. We've got... Thank you. Eh? No one wanted to answer the door. He's selling pictures. I think his name was Martin as well, funny enough, I did see on it. No one wanted to go to the door.
I'm not dressed.
Oh, I've got my hand done.
I've got an injury to my gob. From my son.
He's only trying to earn a living, shall
yeah? I'm not disputing that. You should have
bought
one then. What
picture? No, that's bribery. I can't.
Hey?
Eh? How do we know he was deaf, baby?
To you.
Unbelievable. Right, well, I don't think I'm going to be able to get out in the garden. It's still raining, Jimmy, isn't it?
No.
Well, it's wet out there, isn't it?
Oh, don't talk, but you can still turn. Stop putting
things on. This has turned into a vlog anyway, so.
Any little chance?
No, it's not that shell. I can only do a certain amount of things in the day, can't I?
Right, if you're not going to do that, get on that computer and design a magnet fishing t-shirt.
So there's lots going on today. It doesn't look like I'm going to be able to get out into the garden.
There's lots going on with me.
Eh?
You have lots going
on. Sure, you can't burn wet stuff, baby. So the situation is, it's Sunday, and we normally have a roast on a Sunday.
Well, somebody said last week they'd buy me a nice bit of river beef.
Yeah, I've not been well, Sharon, have I? You know that.
Baby.
I've not been well. So you don't like a roast?
No.
Right, what don't you like about a roast? What part of the roast don't you like? Do you like the meat, the chicken, the... Right, well, okay, so it's chicken roast. So, you like the chicken?
Yeah.
Do you like vegetables?
Some.
You used to love your vegetables.
What vegetables don't you like then?
Brussels sprouts.
We've got loads of them. All right, you ain't got to have the sprouts, that's fair enough. All right, every other vegetable you're okay with?
Yeah, maybe.
Right, roast potatoes?
No, not really. Not the biggest fan.
Right, what about normal potato, mashed potato?
Yeah.
You can have mashed potato instead. Gravy?
No.
How can you not have a roast?
Like that for a phase of not having gravy, so did Gary.
Very strange. A roast to me is the meat, Yorkshire puddings maybe, all the vegetables, roast potatoes, roast parsnips, roast this, that, the other. Maybe a stuffing. Maybe a stuffing.
That
flies in here.
On the oven.
Hold on, wait there.
Well, you're gonna get a scissors and cut it up.
Where was it?
On the oven.
We've got a big fly in this kitchen. I don't like it. I can hear it buzzing. We'll have to see if we can get hold of it.
Will you stop talking about it?
Yeah, all right, baby. So, what was I saying? Yeah, all the trimmings. That's what a proper roast should be. And that's what you've been brought up with. And that's what you're having today.
Do you know, you used to love it as a baby.
Oh. Yeah, he did, actually.
All the kids did. And Gary's a bit funny with a roast and all now, so I don't know why.
Perhaps if I liquidised it and give it to you, would you eat it?
I've had it every Sunday for 18 years.
Yes. Yep, wonderful. Happy days. You love it.
Wonderful. And you don't have it every Sunday.
We'll keep an eye out for it anyway. Anyway, we're going to tinker on anyway. I might have a look at doing something else, but...
You are.
Oh, I said that I was going to do something else, baby. You are. She's got to sort all the decorations up and clean up and that. I've got to maybe catch this fly. I've got to spend a lot of time trying to catch this fly now with this high voltage zapping gun. And we'll see you again in the next video. Me and my little baby. As you can see, I'm nearly over my virus at the moment. Eh? I'm wet. I got caught in the rain, didn't I? I've not worked hard enough to work up the sweat.
I didn't see that.
You and your little lippy bumpy on her lippy there, look, how about that? Hey? So say tonight to everyone, thank everyone for coming.
Thank you.
Yeah, and we'll see you again in the next video, maybe a vlog. We'll see you again in the next video. Until later.
Bye for now.
Bye for now. See you later, bye. It's not yet, Sharon.
I'm putting the tray up.
Unbelievable. He's left that blinking skateboard on the floor here, look. Unbelievable, and he's gone upstairs. Unbelievable. I don't know.